Hi, this will be a rough overview of how to make a basic renderer. What you're seeing on the screen right now is not simply a triangle. However, it's the culmination of a complex process of uploading to vertex pools and dispatching draw calls indirectly based on a set of render parameters. However, I will go into that further. But first, does this look like on the surface? Well, you can see I have a shader that I'm simply reading to a string from the file system and uploading that to my Bevy asset server. For your engine, what you need is an asset, some sort of way to manage assets. You're going to need a way to manage entities and components and systems, so essentially how you're going to manage your data. And you're going to want some sort of general scaffolding that comes with any sort of engine that you will create. Here you can see I have a camera. The camera is necessary to be defined in this implementation. However, nothing is actually being done with the camera at this current point. Then you can see I have a mesh, which just has three vertices and three indices, and also a mesh renderer, which takes the shader. And if you're curious, this is what the shader looks like. This has the vertices, it has draw indirect commands, it has data, payloads, push constants, and but this is the bulk of it. This is what the vertex shader is, and this is what the fragment shader is. Now for the actual renderer. Starting off is the extraction of the resolution. And also getting my entity component system in sync with the main thread. So essentially, I have the renderer working on one separate thread on a whole separate batch of threads. And I have my main game loop on a its own thread, its own batch of threads. And what that allows is that the game loop is able to run while the renderer is working on the next frame. So what this entire function is doing is just getting the information in sync at the point of extraction, at the point where the game loop and the renderer meet up. So that's what this is all doing. It's just extracting components and extracting information. Now you can see I have a number of systems which I am using in order to perform the rendering. However, the first one I want to show is the staging buffer. So essentially what a staging buffer is it's a ring buffer that lives both on the CPU and the GPU and allows data to be written into the staging buffer and then copied from the staging buffer to another location on the GPU. And that's what this is all doing. This is doing the general housekeeping that's necessary for a staging buffer. Now for the vertex pool, what this is doing is it's sectioning off buckets, and a bucket is like I have 100 vertices in order to make this duck model or to make a teapot model. And I have 300 indices. Well, the vertex bucket size is only 50, so it's going to take two buckets to upload 100. Or, for example, if I have 75 vertices, it's still going to take two buckets because I have to allocate the over what the amount of vertices I want to allocate is. And that's for the vertices and the indices. And what it's doing is it's just sectioning off these buckets. It's growing its growable buffer, and what a growable buffer is a buffer that is at least a certain size, and it automatically grows to make that size. And the vertex buffer then also creates a draw indirect command, which then will be sent to the GPU such that the draw call not only is being dispatched on the GPU, but the data for that draw call is also already on the GPU. So it's incredibly fast. And that's what you want. You want incredibly fast, you know what I'm saying? Oh, this stuff gets me excited. And that's what this is doing. It's just It's uploading the vertices and indices to the saving buffer to the relevant locations in the growable buffers for those buckets on the vertex pool, in the vertex pool. And then for the vertex pool, you'll also need an indirect buffer, which is like the reference into, it's where the draw commands live. It's where the draw indirect commands live. And it's very similar to how the vertices work. It's a growable buffer, and I take out a ticket, like the buckets are, they're kind of like a ticket system that you'd find at a deli. And I upload a payload, so it's not only limited to the draw indirect command, and here you can see the payload must be a reprc struct with the indirect command first. And I will also show what the payload looks like, but essentially it will contain like model information and, for example, like the albedo or the translation. Now for the meat of the renderer, here you can see the actual payload. So the payload, like I said, has albedo, translation, and rotation. And then I have what is called my parameters. And the parameters at this moment is just the shader as the source code. And what the parameters is that for every, the vertex pool contains all the vertices in the entire game. However, I may only want to render some of the vertices with one shader and the rest of the vertices with another shader. And so in order to do that, I need these parameters that serves as a key where the value is the indirect buffer that contains all of the draw indirect commands. And so how that works is I basically, you can see I'm committing and uncommitting, but more specifically, I'll look at the commit, the committing. As for the parameters, I section off in the indirect buffer with the draw commands, which is uploaded or updated through the payload. And here you can see I'm doing some general housekeeping for the entity component system. So this block of code, the prune entities, is just unsectioning buckets that are part of entities which no longer exist. Update meshes is if a mesh is added or changed, or if the mesh renderer is added or changed, then it just updates the vertices and the indices and the relevant information on the GPU. And update payload will update like the transform information or the albedo of the payload, which lives in the indirect buffer. And for prepare record, what I do, so basically I have four stages. I have preparing for recording, preparing for render, and rendering. And so everything that you've seen so far is preparing to record, at least in the renderer. And then what I do is for the ultimate task for the renderer, this belongs in the record function. I just want to make sure that I'm correct here. So here you can see prepare record, prune entities, update meshes, and update payload are prepared to record. The renderer task, the staging buffer task, and the vertex pool task are in record. And then prepare render and render I will get into very, very shortly here. But for the renderer task, what you can see is that for every indirect buffer, I want to invoke its task because it's secondary to the renderer. And then for every camera and every pair of render parameters and indirect buffer, I then draw everything that is referenced by that indirect buffer with the parameters that were specified and with the camera information. And that's what this is all doing. It's just a pretty standard render pipeline where you see we start the render pass and then we do the push constant and then we set the resolution, we set the pipeline, etc., etc., etc. In prepare to render, what I do is I just tell the render graph that of course I'm going to want to present to the screen. I'm also going to want to submit. And then it completes the render graph builder, and then it creates an actual render graph and puts that in the world. And then in render, I just call render on the render graph, and the rest of the magic of the render graph happens, and then you see something on the screen. Just to make sure I'm showing everything, this is what the shader looks like. It's just a shader asset. This is what the camera information looks like. This is, let me see, what the mesh information looks like. And yeah, that, if you enjoyed this video, please, please, it helps me out so much and it gets this information out to more people. Leave a like on the video and it will also tell me that I'm doing a good job of improving and I can go from there. So thank you. I've taken up enough of your time. Have a wonderful day.